everybody, and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I have a Schmincke soft pastel haul, as well as a review and setup of the Jack Richeson's The Roz Box 2. Now in today's video, I'm going to be reviewing the box as well as setting it up and sharing with you some of these Schmincke pastels that I have here in front of me. I've got a little bit more than 50 open stock here. This is not all from one order. I have been collecting these behind the scenes for the last 8 months to add to the 100 wood box set that I received as a gift. So if you have not seen that video, shame on you. No, I'm kidding. But if you haven't seen that video of the unboxing of the 100 wood box Schmincke soft pastel set, I will leave that linked up in the iCards as well as the description box down below in case you guys were interested. But for today, what I'm going to do is I'm going to be opening up the rest of the open stock and putting together that half stick set that I bought the Roz box for. I'd also like to mention that the foam inserts that come with these Schmincke boxes of open stock pastels, these are really thick, really nice quality foam inserts, and I'll be saving all of these to put into my own wooden box to make my own half stick sets for other things in the future. So I'm not tossing this foam out. The other foam that you get in the Blick boxes is not terrible. Oh, look at that. There's a Mount Vision in there that I forgot about. But the rest are Schmincke. This foam is not quite as good. It comes apart like this, as you can see. But you can keep it and glue it down inside of a wooden box. And I have done that in the past as well. And it's worked absolutely fine. But the stuff in here, this is really primo stuff. I want to keep this 100%. It's nice and thick, good quality. So I am going to organize all these pastels because unfortunately, even though I bought like entire collections of things, like for example, Ultramarine Light here, I have M here and O, but then they threw in a permanent yellow lemon in there. I got the whole, like I've got 4 or 5 tints of that Ultramarine Light, but they don't organize them when they send them to you, unfortunately, so it's all completely random. So I'll have to spend time off camera organizing them back into their perspective groupings. So I'm not gonna waste your time showing you that, but then I'll share with you what I got. Okay, so I have taken the time to sort everything out and put everything where it belongs, kind of organize everything in their perspective groupings. But something that happened I didn't even realize is as I was collecting these over the last 8 or so months, at somewhere along the line I'd also picked up some Mount Vision pastels in the greens to finish out my set of those, and I didn't even realize it was sitting there in that box with them. So I'm happy that I did this. Now this color grouping might look a little bit odd on its own, but what I did was I bought the ones that I knew were not in the 100 wood box set that I knew I'd want to kind of fill in. So there, a lot of these color groupings will be incomplete for the reason that I've got them already in that 100 wood box set. But I'm not going to show that again on camera because I already did in the unboxing video. So if you want to see that, I'll leave that linked up. So what I did was I grabbed, over here I've got some cerulean blues, which are really beautiful. Ultramarine lights to finish my set. The Delft blue, which is gorgeous, you guys. Their Delft blue is just so vibrant, it's amazing. I've got some Pazuli Earth, Golden Ochres, and a few Siennas to finish out what that box didn't have. Now, something that did happen was I ended up purchasing this one twice, the Golden Ochre Light O, unfortunately, but it is PY42 and it's a light color that I use a ton in my artwork, so I know that I'll end up using it up. I end up getting a couple of greens, including this really saturated kind of extra dark phthalo green. Grabbed an extra yellow. I picked up some browns here. One of them did come kind of crumbled, but you know, that kind of does happen. This color is one of my favorites.
And I'm sorry the camera's not able to focus on tiny things sometimes. Let's see if we can get it to focus on that. This color is Orange Deep B, so it has the black added. And it looks just like Pumpkin Spice. Like, it's this gorgeous Pumpkin Spice shade. I just had to have that one. I bought some colors to fill in the reds and pinks that the set didn't have, because I knew right away I wanted all the reds that they had and all the pinks that they had, because they're the most luscious. And I ended up getting quite a few more purples as well. And this shade here is pretty interesting. It's called Quinacridone Violet B, but I like it because it kind of looks like a burnt carmine. So burnt carmine is one of my favorite shades in pastel, so I wanted it for that reason. Now here's something I did want to show you, and I'm going to mount the camera back up so I can keep the camera stable while I show you this, but there is something I wanted to show you about the labels.
All right, so here I have a Rembrandt pastel, and here I have a Schmincke pastel. Again, this isn't a comparison between Rembrandt and Schmincke. This is not about quality or anything like that. But the reason I wanted to show you this is because there's something about the Schmincke labels that I'm not completely happy with, and here's what it is. So all your information is on one side of the label. You've got the color number, color name, the light fast information, and pigment information. It's on this one side. Turn it over, and of course you have the Schmincke label. So if you're going to be peeling off the label, which you have to at some point, you're going to be losing some critical information. You're either going to have to choose to lose the pigment information or the color name and number. What I did for this one is apparently I decided to preserve light, fast, and pigment information, but I sacrificed the color name and number. This is a problem because most of the time we're going to break our pastel sticks in half to work with them. And now if I lose that little piece of paper, and inevitably, you know, now I don't know how to repurchase this. Like, I don't know what color this is just to look at it. With the Rembrandt labels, you get the color number. This is 370-5 up at the top, but then they print it five more times. So it's printed on there six times total, all the way across the band. So no matter how much you tear it out, you're going to have that information to reorder. And the pigment information is toward one side and the color name is toward that one side versus being on the top all displayed. It's all to one side. So I've always kind of peeled that part off, and then I've still got the information for reorder. Now, for some artists, this is going to be really marginal. Like, it's just not gonna matter, because a lot of artists will be like, you know, they'll have a box of pastels that they don't keep the information for, and that they would just look at this and go, okay, well, this is a scarlet red, and as they're running low on it, I'll just go repurchase another similar scarlet red. They don't need this exact one again. But for me, I really wanted to be able to repurchase this exact one again. So I wish that they had that printed, at least the number printed on there more times. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at the Jack Richeson's The Roz Box 2. Now, the reason it says Roz Box 2 is because there are two removable plastic trays in here that hold up to 68 oversized pastels. So that's why the 2, because there's going to be two trays. So let's talk about this box. I have conflicted feelings about this, to be very honest. I know that I can make something very similar to this myself for just a fraction of the cost. In fact, if you guys were interested in seeing that video, let me know in the description. Let me know in the comment section down below, and I will be more than happy to do that video. So this reminds me very much of a toolbox or a bake and tackle box. This was like $80, and this handle is plastic. It might look like metal on camera, but it is actually It's plastic. So it's coated in some silver paint or something that inevitably will start chipping away. The outside is really texturized with like this diamond texture. And it's kind of aggressive to look at and to touch. I really don't like it. It doesn't have a very expensive feel to it. And I'm going to be really honest and say that I don't think that you're getting $80 worth of value here. Let's go ahead and open it up. So here is the inside. You get these plastic trays here with the foam on the underside. This craft foam you can buy for like 79 cents a roll at Michael's. It's really inexpensive. It's like a large sheet, and then you'd cut it down to whatever size you wanted. This foam here is a cheaper, lesser quality foam. It looks like disposable packing material, to be very honest. If you compare it to this foam that the Schmincke open stock pastels shipped in that is supposed to be disposable, you'll likely see that this is better quality. So now again, without the insert, the foam, you could still put your pastels into the plastic, but they'd move around more and they wouldn't be as protected. Underneath the Richeson plate, there's a hole. So you're gonna have to stuff this with something. And this is something I saw the reviewers comment on, and I can say this is absolutely true. The reviewers on the website is, if you have a pastel here and a pastel here, it's gonna be sliding under here, underneath this plate. So you're gonna have to stuff this with a tissue or paper towel or something, because otherwise they're gonna be falling and rolling into there. And then of course you have another tray, and this is lined with that same Michael's kind of craft store foam that you can purchase and that I have purchased to line my own pastel boxes before. I noticed that some of the hinges on mine on the outside were already a tiny bit rusted when I got this, and I did purchase it brand new. And that silver paint or whatever it is that's coating the plastic handle is already kind of starting to wear a teeny tiny bit. Now, if you don't care about those things, and you likely might not, then, you know, those are just aesthetic things, most likely. But again, $80. Will it protect your pastels and keep it safe? Yes, I think they absolutely will. But can you find a storage solution for less that will do the exact same thing and serve the same function? Yes, I do believe you can. So here's a Schmincke pastel. We'll put that in there. Let's try an oversized pastel, since that's the claim it's touting. Let's go get a Mount Vision. They are the chunkiest, thickest pastels I have. Okay, I ran and I got one of my Mount Vision beauties. These pastels, the Mount Vision pastels, these really are my pride and joy. So they have to be stored in something safe. Let's see. All right. So there it is. It did fit, but it's a tight fit with the foam still in there. And I'm wondering if I had an even chunkier Mount Vision, because some of them are a little bit chunkier than that, if it would still fit. All right, I ran and I got another Mount Vision. This one is definitely the chunkiest, fattest, thickest one I have. And as you know, handmade or hand-rolled pastels, they're all a little bit different. They're not going to be all uniform in size like the factory extruded ones. So you have some of those irregularities. Let's go ahead and see. Yeah, that's not going to fit too well with the foam. Just barely. But, you know, taking them in and out to use them, it's going to bring the foam quite a bit with it. Yeah, I mean, it is squeezing the foam down on the sides. I have to lift the foam back up to get it in there. So it just barely fits, but honestly, I'd say it's just a bit too big. Let's go ahead and close it down, make sure it's not hitting anything. No, it's definitely gonna close. It didn't seem like it touched the top either, because there would have been some dust that touched the top. So It will hold the Mount Visions, especially some of the more standard size ones, but the extra chunky ones, I think it's going to struggle with a little bit, to be honest. It's kind of a little bit difficult to get them in and out with the foam insert. Of course, if I take the foam out, then you still have that compartment, you have that option, and it's going to be fine. So you might consider taking these little foam inserts out if you find that it's fitting a little too snug. All right, so I'm going to set up the box and then I'll give my overall final thoughts for the review portion of this video. But for now, some of my thoughts here for now are that A, I think that it's not $80 worth of value. Is it a nice box? Yes, but you know, it didn't cost that much to make. I guess I'm just saying that I feel like if I had it to do over again, would I repurchase this? Likely not. To be completely honest, I would have just did my own thing, I think. Or got a pastel cabinet because I like it, don't get me wrong, but I do also feel like, you know, it's kind of cheaply made, and I have to be honest, my first responsibility has to be to you guys, the viewers. I think they could have done better for that $80 price tag. So I honestly, this is the first product on my whole channel that I'd have to say, I don't think I recommend this, to be completely honest. I think that you can do better for your money. The other thing that's kind of a real deal breaker for me is that this does advertise that it fits the oversized pastels specifically. It's marketed toward those in particular. Would I be comfortable putting my Mount Vision pastels in here? No, honestly, I wouldn't, because I'd have to take these foam inserts out that really cushion and protect the pastel to really get them to fit very good in here. At least the really chunky ones, because I would be pulling when I went to pull this pastel out that was here, every time I pulled the thick green one out, I was pulling the foam out with it because it was just too tight of a fit. So for that purpose, I know a lot of people love this, and I'm so torn because I feel like I'm going to get backlash for saying this, but I honestly think that I'm disappointed in it, to be honest. I honestly think that you can do better for the money. Now, am I comfortable putting my Schmincke pastels in here? Yes, because they fit much better, and I do like having the two trays, and I love having the option to do my own half stick set here, and that's what I'm going to do with those Schmincke pastels, which I'm already planning to use in an upcoming painting. I'm going to use them in a couple different methods, a couple different techniques, and then I'll be doing a full review on these. So make sure to stick around to the channel and subscribe if you guys are interested in seeing that, because I want to really put these pastels through the paces and give a full and comprehensive review where I've used a variety of techniques and used them in multiple applications, so that I can really give you the benefit of my opinion and experience with them. But because they are the smaller size, you know, I feel very comfortable putting them in here. And for the price, I want to make sure that they're very well protected, and I do think that this box can do that. So it delivers on their claims mostly. But the quality of the box is where I take issue. I'm not satisfied with the quality of it, to be very, very honest. All right, so here's my plan to set up this box. I would like to do a half stick set of the Schmincke pastels that I have. I'm going to be combining pastels from the 100 wood box set, as well as the pastels that I got open stock over the last 8 months or so to supplement the colors. And I'll move things around. I might not include every color in the 100 wood box set. I want to make this as useful and custom for myself as possible. I ran and grabbed a watercolor brush because I was hoping that the lighter color you'd be able to see the handle really well. I want to show you one of the problems with this box, and this is a little irritating. So if I have a pastel here and a pastel here, this is an empty void under this plate, and legitimately, hopefully you can see right through. Okay, do you see that? I hope this shows up on camera, but that means that the pastels are going to slide underneath of here and things aren't going to be great. So I'm going to have to find something to stuff, something that's going to be acid free, archival safe, and stuff under here so that the pastels won't be going through. Maybe some of that packing foam might be a good idea. All right, so what I'd like to do here at this point is wrap up this review for the Roz box with a pros and cons list. Bear in mind as we go along that this retails for around $100 list price, and you can pick this up for just around $70 at dickblick.com. So let's start with the pros. I think this is a really travel-friendly solution. It's not the only travel-friendly option. There are plein air boxes and other options available for pastels, but this is a good one. It is an option, and it does do what it claims to do. It's relatively sturdy and secure. Your pastels are going to be safe in here. I do believe that. But the problem is that I don't think that the construction is built to last, and I'll talk about a little bit more about that in just a second. I do like the snap closures, and I do like the functionality of the box. For my cons list, these don't fit all the oversized pastels like they claim to. As you already saw, it was just a bit too snug to fit some of my Mount Visions. They just didn't fit in there comfortably. The quality is another con. I'd have expected more, just to be completely honest, for the price point on these. I really would have expected more. The interior and the exterior walls move in and out quite a bit, as I've showed you. I'll insert a clip to demonstrate that.
I'm just going to be really truthful and honest with you guys. I'm going to show you an up close. This is the exterior wall of the outside of the Roz box. I'm just going to push on it and show you, okay? Okay, hopefully you can see that. I am not pushing hard, but this really isn't. This is moving in and out. I don't think the construction is super sturdy on this, you guys. Yeah.
I've already begun to see a little bit of rust on the hinges, and the handle and snap closures are plastic. So it seems to me very much that this is like a bait and tackle box. Underneath the nameplate, there is a hollow void that needs to be filled, as I've already demonstrated. Now, I just shoved a piece of scrap foam in there. You could also shove a napkin or a paper towel or something in there, and that fixes that problem. But it is kind of annoying, just to be completely honest. I wish they had thought that through a little bit better. I also feel that this is a little bit expensive for what you're getting, because the value is just not there. I just don't think that you're getting $100 worth of value. That's not the quality that we're talking about here, in my opinion. I think that this is an overpriced bait and tackle box. And lastly, my last con, and this is personal preference, but the texture, that diamond texture on the outside, is really obnoxious. It reminds me of like a meat tenderizer or a cheese grater. It's obnoxious. Now, of course, looks are subject to opinion, so you might really like the way that that looks, so it might not be a con for you, but to me it is. It's really not an attractive design at all. I don't really enjoy handling it or looking at it. And one more thing that I wanted to mention is that I've had this box for about, oh, maybe a week and a half, 2 weeks now. I began filming quite a while back there, so I don't want you to think that I filmed this all in one day, because I've been filming a lot of this over the span of the last 2 weeks or so. I've had a lot of other things I've had to do, and every time that I go to open this box, several times the first tray will get stuck to the inside lid. It'll start to like lift up when I go to open it. Like, it'll get stuck and then it'll pick up that tray, if you know what I mean. So, you know, that's kind of annoying, but it seems like that foam is going to become damaged on the inside lid from that repeated, you know, from that repeated sticking and from that happening. So I can't tell you how it fits the Unison pastels, but I can tell you for the Mount Visions, which are very similar in size and they're both hand rolled pastels, it was too snug of a fit for me. I didn't think that they were safe in there like that. Now, of course, you could remove the little bit of foam padding, but that's at your own discretion. I like it. I will get use out of it. I will enjoy it. And I do think that it's a good travel option, a good storage option. But, you know, I really think that there's a lot of improvements that could be made to this, and I hope that they do make those improvements in the future. That's really all I guess I'm saying on this one. So, I was disappointed. I'll be honest. I was disappointed with the quality of this box. That really does wrap up the review for today. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you found this video helpful and you got value from the video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. Be sure to keep an eye out for that Schmincke soft pastel review, which will be coming in the future. And you guys know I put a lot of pride, a lot of hard work and dedication into my product reviews, so you can be sure that I'm going to give you my honest thoughts on that. And as always, have a great day, and I hope you're enjoying your summer. See you guys in the next one. Bye.